I have the option of sensors, for example, and I can double-click. Here are all the sensors. Among these, I have engine coolant temperature, and here it will show me the temperature value, and it will show me the voltage value. Everything comes out. For example, here is the voltage of intake temperature. Voltage of the engine coolant temperature sensor signal. So I can monitor the sensor's voltage as the temperature increases or decreases in the engine. Let's say I put a cardboard in the radiator. I block it so that it heats up faster. I have it accelerated to force the engine. And I'm waiting for the temperature to rise. So I can monitor the voltage that should change. And I can monitor the temperature value. Obviously, there is something curious about the fan issue, and that is when I check the system by temperature. At what temperature, from 200 to 210, let's say, depending on the engine. There's one that ranges from 2 to 3, 2 to 5, 2 to 10, 2 to 12 Fahrenheit. At 12 Celsius, the engine has burned out a long time ago. At what temperature does the thermostat open? It depends, that varies, 182, 180, 190, that varies. In Celsius, 80, 82, that varies depending on the manufacturer. Not all engines are identical. How do you test a thermostat? How do you know if it's opening or not? Let's calculate the time it takes for the customer and the time it takes for you. Because that's what it's worth. If you take these courses, it's because you want to learn how to do things in a better way. So look at this, I have my customer's refrigerant. Since they have refrigerant and won't buy it, I have to collect it. So I have to find a clean container, place it underneath, open the radiator. But it's hot, so I have to wait for the engine to cool down so I don't burn myself. I open the radiator. Remove the refrigerant from the equipment, lower the thermostat, tie it with a small wire, and go to the kitchen. I put a pot of hot water to boil. I put my thermostat in and measure the temperature. 80 degrees Celsius, 81, 82, it opened. It opened at 82 degrees, done. Wonderful. That's how they used to do it. How are you going to do it now? I sit in my office with the air conditioning on. I connect my scanner, I have my Bluetooth interface. So I don't have to be out there with the truck. In the sun, I don't have my truck in the office, I can't exaggerate either. I have my Bluetooth interface or I have a long cable. I stretch my cable to the truck, I have it connected from the office, I start the engine, I put the cardboard to warm up faster, I set the cruise speed at 1500 revolutions so it can heat up faster, and I'm sitting in the office staring at the computer, and if you observe, the temperature will start rising. 70 degrees, 75, 80 degrees, well, let's put it like this, 75, 76, 77, it gradually increases. The more it heats up, the slower it increases. 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 82, 81, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85. At that moment when you see that the temperature was rising constantly, I mean, it increased by 1 degree every so often, 79, 80, 81, 82. And instead of continuing to increase, it stopped. And it stayed there for a while. It even dropped by 1 or 2 degrees, 81, 80. And then it started to rise again, 81, 82, 83. At that moment when the temperature stopped and dropped by 1 or 2 degrees, it was because the thermostat opened. I mean, I don't have to lower the thermostat to know that it's opening, I just have to sit and observe. It's just that this business. I say that I'm lazy as a mechanic, but it's not that I'm lazy. It's that I'm one of those who thinks that the less I take apart, the less I have to put back together, and it's not that I'm too lazy to take things apart. It's just that if you sit down and analyze things calmly, you can get to the fault more quickly. If I act crazy and lower the thermostat, I'll lower everything to check. I'll be a mess, I'll take too much time. I'll start costing the customer. No, it's because I threw away the refrigerant, so we need to buy new refrigerant. And then we need to buy some silicone because we're going to apply it to the thermostat. We're going to change the gasket, so buy the Cummins gasket. And that's unnecessary, I could look at it with the scanner. And know if it's working or not. I take a good car, from different brands. I take a 2250, a 2150, a Cummins, a CAT. When they're in good condition. and I stay with each car for a while analyzing how a car that works well behaves. What pressures it shows, do a road test how much does the turbo open, for example how do you know if a turbo is not sending the pressure it should? What if, on ISX, gentlemen? More or less, it doesn't have to be exact. Maximum pressure of a Cummins, ISX turbo 28, 30, 40. 40 is very high pressure. I'm not saying it can't give it, it can, but it's misconfigured. Hoses can burst. I would tell you that the normal pressure for an engine of that type is between 30 and 35 pounds more or less. 33, 34, 35, those are normal pressures, very good for working. 30 pounds, it's still working very well, but 28, that seems a bit low to me. 28 is a very good pressure for a smaller engine, an 11 liter, a 12 liter. For a 15 liter, about 35 pounds is powerful, it's good. If you know this, you do the test and know, the pressure is too low. Because at some point you got into a car that was fine and saw that the pressure was higher. The barometric pressure, let's look it up here. The barometric pressure is at 8.4 pounds per square inch. I'm telling you it's wrong. No, engineer, the car has low power, the sensor is bad or there's a problem in the circuit, something's going on. Because here in Barranquilla, in my city the pressure is 14.7 pounds per square inch, it's the atmospheric pressure at sea level. So I already know that this sensor is bad because that parameter shouldn't be measured here. This parameter should be measured in Bolivia at the highlands of La Paz, which are at 4,000 meters above sea level. But the sensor for barometric pressure doesn't give me a fault code because this is a real pressure, it's just for a different altitude, not for mine. So you see, knowing what values to expect is what helps me diagnose quickly and efficiently. The thermostat, try it as I tell you and you will realize that it is like that. The temperature gradually increases and stops and drops 1 or 2 degrees and then starts again. That tells me that the thermostat opened. Ah, well, it may be bad. It may not open enough. In that case, you will see that the interval of time is very short, almost imperceptible. That is, it keeps gradually increasing, but over time you catch on to the timing. I know how long it takes more or less, and I already know it's good. Of course, look for a car that is good. So you have a point of comparison. Measure a car to see what pressure it shows you. Even the barometric pressure is standard. That is, if I measure a Cummins, I measure a Detroit. A Cat, I measure a MaxiForce. They should all show me a similar pressure. 14.7 pounds per square inch, which is the pressure in my city. That is, at sea level, where I am. But you have to know how much it is, so you know what's wrong. So those are the kinds of things. But it's about knowing the equipment, and once you know it, observing, take the trouble to observe how it behaves. Engineer, what happens is that it tells me that there is no water detected, that must mean it's dry. No, but you look at all the cars, it's okay not to detect water in the fuel. That's how it has to come out. So you already know what to expect in a car or not.